Chaos outside of Pfizer Forum. We are following new developments in Milwaukee after a shooting near the Bucks playoff game. Thanks for joining us, everyone. I'm Chris Stanford. We start with that breaking news in Milwaukee this morning. Two separate shootings downtown after the Bucks playoff loss. Police say 17 people were shot and injured just after 11 p.m., about 2 hours after the game ended. This video here shows the scene near Water Street and Highland Avenue. Police say the victims range in age from 15 to 17 years old. Police say all should survive. Authorities say 10 people were taken into custody and officers recovered 9 weapons. The latest from Milwaukee police is that they are still looking for more suspects. Then, just about 2 hours earlier and just blocks away, another shooting. 3 people were shot near Pfizer Forum right after the game ended. The video taken here last night outside of the stadium shows police trying to keep the crowds back from the scene of the crime. The video from a reporter with our news partner CBS 58 captured it at 9:20 last night at MLK and Highland, where officers are trying to control the crowds. Milwaukee police releasing some new details this morning on that shooting. Officers have a 29-year-old in custody in the shooting near the stadium. The victims include a 16-year-old girl, a 26-year-old man, and a 29-year-old man. All of those victims are expected to survive as well. Police are investigating what led up to both shootings. The one near the stadium did not happen in the Deer District, where crowds of fans watch the games. We will push out any updates on either shooting today through our News 3 Now mobile app. You can download it this morning wherever you get yours. It is graduation day for UW-Madison, so expect a crowd downtown today. This year, the ceremonies have all returned in person, and parents and family are allowed to attend. Last year, the ceremony took place at Camp Randall with no spectators allowed for the graduates. It'll also be Chancellor Becky Blank's last commencement as chancellor. Earlier this week, she held her final media briefing where she said a lot about her time in Madison.
Because of these investments and others, UW has steadily improved as an educational institution. We were always very good. We are even better now.
Chancellor Blank's last day will be Friday, May 26th. That commencement ceremony taking place at noon at Camp Randall for all bachelor's, master's, and law degree candidates. The keynote speaker is U.S. Representative to the UN, Linda Thomas-Greenfield. Expect some game day-like traffic downtown today, and if you don't have reservations to eat out tonight, probably better off at home. All right, let's check in with Julian C. right now. That's certified most accurate. Hey, Julian.
And we're looking at some gorgeous conditions outside as of right now. Seeing that sun just starting to beam down on us as we're continuing throughout the rest of our morning hours. And on top of it, well, we're going to be seeing those temperatures really starting to be a bit mild as we're kicking things off. 68 degrees right now, but it feels great outside. Dew points are very comfortable, and we're not looking at much in terms of winds either. So temperatures around southern Wisconsin, 66 in Janesville with 65 in Platteville, and still just a couple areas into the mid 50s, but a nice start to our Saturday, especially nicer start than we've had in the last couple of days, where we've already been seeing 70s and 80s around this time of day. But planning out the rest of it, well, we will see the 80s. It's just going to be on a lower end, and it's going to be later today. Around this afternoon, we're going to be seeing the warmer summer-like feel for us, but for those that are going to be at the commencement, well, it's going to be pretty good for us, and even great weather if you have any yard work that you need to get done as well, because we're looking at plenty of sunshine. It's going to be pretty nice as well. Definitely a lot more spring-like than what we've had in the last couple of days, Chris.
Less humid?
Less humid. Oh, so much more
thank
comfortable.
Goodness.
It's going to be great.
All right. Thank you very much. Yeah. Police say 2 people were seriously injured and in the hospital after a fire on the interstate. The DOT says a semi-truck caught fire near Linden Station on I-90 yesterday morning. The fire could be seen from this traffic camera showing the backup in the eastbound lanes, too. DOT says both trucks were carrying flammable substances. Crews once again repairing multiple pavement buckles in southern Wisconsin. The first happened around 2 o'clock on southbound Highway 51 near Portage. The second was reported around the eastbound lanes of Highway 12 south of Baraboo, and a third on Highway 33 near Beaver Dam. So what makes southern Wisconsin so vulnerable to these buckling roads? According to the Wisconsin DOT Director of Technical Services, it's the local material.
Local type of quartzite that tends to have very expansive properties, thermal expansion, just, you know, the way I like to explain it, like your siding on your house. You can hear it shrink in the winter and crack. In the summer, it expands. The Baraboo quartzite tends to have very expansive properties. So that was the locally available material to build that road, and that was with what's in there, and that's what's causing some of that problem in there.
More on the heat now. In northeastern Wisconsin, things were so hot yesterday that the Appleton Area School District canceled all classes and events. In a notice to parents, the school district cited extreme heat and higher than average staff absences. In the morning, when district officials checked temperatures in classrooms, they were still at 80 to 85 degrees.
Of course, we have fans. The teachers do a great job of doing everything they can, but it came to a point at which we were seeing conditions that we didn't feel were safe for the kids or students today.
School district officials say only 3 of their 27 school buildings have air conditioning in Appleton. A quick COVID update from the Department of Health Services. Cases are once again rising, so much so that 7 Wisconsin counties are now back at a high level of transmission. That means the CDC recommends that people wear masks again. DHS says more than 2,000 new cases have been reported in the past 24 hours. Happening today, groups speaking out against the potential reversal of Roe versus Wade have indicated online they will be protesting across the country today. Police Chief Sean Barnes says that they are working with several agencies to make sure the protesting remains safe, including increasing patrols. MPD expects there to be several thousand people. That's in addition to many coming downtown for UW commencement. Many business owners near the square didn't want to talk to us on camera about this, but one who did says that he's not worried about crowds or conflict.
Biggest thing is when people hear about an event like this or any protest or march, whatever, people are afraid to come downtown because they're not sure of what's going to happen, especially after the event a couple years ago where everything broke loose.
Madison Police Chief Sean Barnes saying yesterday that his department supports the rights granted to people by the First Amendment and is hopeful that all gatherings will remain peaceful. New this morning, the Wisconsin Parole Commission's chair has rescinded parole for a man convicted of killing his wife back in 1997 after family of the victims met with Governor Tony Evers. After that meeting, the governor wrote to the head of the Parole Commission asking that they not release Douglas Balsiewicz. He would have been eligible for parole as soon as Tuesday after serving less than 25 years of his 80-year sentence. If you have a baby to feed, then chances are you know well about the ongoing formula shortage sweeping the country. We've told you before what not to do, but now we're looking for solutions that you can access here at home. Our Naomi Coles reports.
It's been messing with his weight. Some families are driving up to an hour to go find formula.
It's just absolutely barren.
Nationwide, parents are fighting to feed their babies in a shortage driven by supply chain disruptions and a safety recall of a widely popular brand.
It's scary for families wondering if you're going to be able to feed your baby or not.
We set out to find you help in Madison, starting here at the Pregnancy Helpline on the east side.
Right now we're providing 1 can of formula per month per client so that we can spread that wealth out a little bit more and make sure that everybody's getting a little bit of something.
Executive Director Brenda Collins says their client counts are rising. Their formulas, distributed for free, are donated from Second Harvest, individual donations, and hospitals.
Anybody that can make it to our center will serve. So we actually have clients coming from 8 different counties to receive support.
Another option, milk banks.
20% of the milk that we pasteurize actually goes directly to families whose babies are very often unable to digest traditional formulas.
The Mother's Milk Bank of the Western Great Lakes serves Illinois and Wisconsin and has a dispensary here in Madison.
It's always a good idea to check with your provider to see what's appropriate for your baby specifically, but very often human milk is a very appropriate option for families looking to feed their babies.
They serve short-term walk-ins, but also long-term clients with a doctor's prescription.
Right now, we have a fantastic supply of donor milk because our donors answered the call. Earlier this year, we were experiencing a little bit of a shortage with our milk supply, but our donors are absolutely fantastic.
While it can be a very pricey option, they work with insurance and they will also adjust prices for lower-income families based on need.
We are able to supply all the milk that's needed for all the demand that we're seeing.
That was Naomi Coles reporting. Right now at channel3000.com, we've listed these and other resources that you can check out if you're on the formula hunt. Plus, a list of do's and don'ts from doctors on how to get your baby through the shortage. An update this morning about 2 dogs found dead in garbage bags along the Ice Age Trail. It happened this week in Verona. The Dane County Sheriff's Department says they have found the owner and has determined that the deaths were accidental and no criminal charges or citations will be issued. A Russian court has extended WNBA star Brittany Griner's pretrial detention on charges of drug smuggling by 1 month. Russian authorities in Moscow arrested Griner in February. She's accused of smuggling hash oil in her luggage, which is punishable by up to 10 years in prison in Russia. The U.S. State Department recently classified Griner's arrest as a wrongful detention. The U.S. Olympic and Paralympic Committee is also working to get her released. And in Kyiv, in court for the first time since the start of the war, a Russian soldier being tried for war crimes. The 21-year-old soldier, part of a tank crew, accused of killing an unarmed civilian while he was riding a bike in the early days of the war. He faces up to life in prison. 8:09 right now, still ahead. We will track that cool down and any more chances of rain or storms over the weekend. A nice little look over the Capitol as the clouds are breaking up and the sun is shining through. Julian has your certified most accurate forecast when we come back.
Sponsored by RG Heating and Air Conditioning, installing train equipment and servicing all brands.
In life are free.
Just wait until he hears about free installation from Feldco.
Free installation? Are you kidding me? Yeah!
Free installation on windows, siding, doors, and roofing. Plus, no interest for 1 year. That's something to get excited about.
Free installation ends soon. Call now.
For quality windows, siding, and doors, call 866 for Feldco.
Frisky's World
looks delicious.
With real shrimp, garden veggies, tasty gravy.
New Frisky's glazed and infused.
It's glazing amazing.
Feed their fantasy.
Frisky's.
Look, there's over 100 more varieties at friskies.com.
At Weedman Lawn Care, we believe that a lush, beautiful lawn should be enjoyed by the whole family. That's why we offer a kid and pet-friendly program to create a healthier, greener, weed-free lawn that your whole family can enjoy. Our program includes effective applications of targeted weed control and slow-release golf course-quality fertilizer to achieve real results. Call or click today for your free quote, or sign up now and see the Weedman difference.
Doesn't your family deserve a weed man lawn?
In Wisconsin, everything's gotten so expensive because America's too dependent on China. So we sure know phony baloney policies when we see them. Senator Ron Johnson voted against cracking down on China with higher tariffs and tougher trade deals, and even voted against punishing China for manipulating its currency. No wonder everything keeps going up and up and up. Senator Johnson, stop making it easier on China and tougher on us.
Contact Culligan, your local water expert.
It's time to set the record straight on who has the best beef. This is the Hy-Vee Beef Standards Book, and here's all you really need to know. Hy-Vee's pickier. Their cattle are even hand-selected. Some make claims, but Hy-Vee has the best beef. That's a fact. So enjoy your Hy-Vee steak this weekend. You've earned it.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Well, we have a gorgeous start to our Saturday morning as the sun is starting to beam down for us and the clouds are still slowly but surely gradually clearing for us as we continue throughout the rest of our morning hours. But it feels pretty great this morning, even though it's a bit on the milder side for our start, 68 degrees. Just take note of the dew points. We're around 59 degree dew points as of right now, and temperatures are into the 60s here in southern Wisconsin, with some of us into the upper 50s, mainly over near Prairie du Chien and Basketball. But as we take a look at the dew points around us, again, we're all into the 50s as of right now, and even some of us into the upper 40s, which means for us that it's very comfortable out and it's not very humid. This is about our scale as we're looking at, oh yeah, it's not bad at all, from 55 to 60 degrees in terms of our dew points for us. So it's really a comfortable day, and it's going to feel like that throughout much of the rest of our Saturday as well. Thanks to the high pressure system, we're looking at plenty of dry conditions. As that low and that system that brought in the showers and storms overnight continues to track its way way east, and we're just going to be looking at warmer conditions heading into the rest of our Saturday. That's what we're going to see as we get into the early parts of our afternoon. Plenty of sun as the clouds clear out, but temperatures will be into those lower and middle 80s for many of us. Then as we go into tonight, we'll start to gradually start to cool down once again, seeing those 60s in our forecast with a bit much more of those clouds starting to roll in and some showers coming into much of southern Wisconsin, mainly between Rock and Green County. But for the most part, we also could see some rain here in Dane County as well overnight into our early Sunday. But then we are looking for another round of it to start to roll its way in as we get into our Sunday afternoon, coming in from the northwest and start to roll its way into south central and southeastern parts of southern Wisconsin as we get into our Sunday evening. And some of those showers could start to produce some thunderstorms for us as well, but that looks to clear up as we get into our later part of Sunday night. Now, a lot of the rain in itself is not looking for too much, but any real strong accumulations that we'll see will be mainly into the southeastern corridor between Rock and Green County for us. But we do have a couple more shots later this week to see some rain, but it's not going to be much for Monday. However, later into the week, around late Tuesday and even for our Wednesdays, when we're looking for another system to start to potentially bring in some rain for us as we get into the mid part of next week. But until then, enjoy this weekend. Temperatures are going to be much cooler than they were for the last few days. However, today is still going to feel more summer-like. Tomorrow is going to be even better. 68 degrees heading into our Sunday. We'll see some mostly cloudy conditions for us. But until then, enjoy the sun while we have it and the warmth as well. Now, as we take a look at what the next few days are going to be showing for us, well, it's going to be a lot more spring-like for us. The temperatures will be into the 60s and 70s with a few shots of seeing some showers or even some thunderstorms. But for the most part, not a bad forecast, just a lot more spring-like for us, even though we've had a real taste of summer over the last few days, Chris.
Much more comfortable over the next week or so.
Yes.
Looking forward to that.
Absolutely.
Remarkable pictures from all the thunderstorms last night.
I saw them.
Some of those lightning strikes caught on photos here from some of our viewers. We want to thank Carol in Brooklyn, Wisconsin, and Jeffrey, who also sent in the photos, capturing, a big, strong line of thunderstorms that pushed through last night. 8:16 now. There's been a lot of rain in the Midwest this spring, and farmers in Minnesota say it's making an impact on planting season. Jared Dean reports from St. Peter.
After a late spring and days of severe weather, Governor Tim Walz has issued an executive order authorizing temporary regulatory relief for motor carriers and drivers for a spring crop in Minnesota. Despite the last couple of days, southern Minnesota farms have not seen the same damage as other areas in the state.
I have not seen any potholes around here standing of water, you know, so that means that the ground is absorbing it all for the plants, you know, for the corn to get started. And give it a good start.
Minnesota has over 65,000 farms and 26 million acres of farmland. Triple E Farms is a part of this with 66 acres of planted corn, 50 acres of alfalfa, and 40 acres of soybean. Farming has been a part of the Enns family for generations.
My grandpa started farming here, and then my dad took over, and then now I'm taking over from my dad, and then I got my two boys involved, and my brother's involved in it too. So it's multiple generations here.
One of the concerns with the late spring is late planting. The last planting date for corn is May 31st, and for beans is June 10th. Enns completed his corn planting on the 12th.
Here in Minnesota a few years ago, more so in central Minnesota and northern Minnesota, we had a lot of acres that were unable to go into the planned crops.
The question remains for farmers with the late planting season and strong storms is how the yields will look come harvest time and how early the frost will come.
Today, Governor Tim Walz will travel to northwest Minnesota to meet with farmers to get a firsthand look of the impact of the severe flooding on the planting season. Well, take a look at this, something you only see here on News 3 Now. Olympic gold medalist curler and McFarland native Matt Hamilton trimming his famous locks, donating his hair to support brain cancer research.
Once I realized the platform I did have, I thought it was a great chance to, try and give back to the community and do something that is near and dear to me. And
yesterday, Hamilton visited a local Great Clip salon, getting his hair cut for the first time in 4 years. It's to raise awareness and money for brain cancer research through his work with Stash Strong. Matt's hair will be donated to Wigs for Kids for children experiencing hair loss due to medical conditions. Happening today, the 7 de Mayo Festival in Stoughton getting underway. It's their annual Norwegian Heritage Festival running through the weekend. It takes place every year on the weekend closest to Norway's May 17th Constitution Day, also known as 7 de Mayo. We have a list of all the times and performances up right now at channel3000.com. 5 years after a deadly plant explosion in Cambria, charges against the company. Still ahead, Didion Milling's response. And there are several new shows and movies to check out this weekend. Will Loper shares his picks in three things to watch. Trending news just ahead on News 3 Now This Morning, Saturday.
At JR's Mulch Sales, mulch is all we do, which is why we do it better. We deliver 10 varieties of mulch 7 days a week, right to your door. Call us today.
JR's Mulch Sales, spread it around.
A breast cancer diagnosis can shake you and your loved ones to the core. At Associated Physicians, we want to remind you that early detection is crucial. Don't put off your routine wellness care any longer. Please make getting your mammogram a priority. Do it for you and those you love. We make it easy. We provide state-of-the-art 3D mammograms on site at our clinic. Schedule your mammogram appointment today at Associated Physicians, 233-9746.
Okay, let's start with some clouds. Some mountains over there. And finally, a river. Hey, Dad, look.
Looks like the perfect spot.
American Family Insurance is here to protect your family on the road with a travel peace of mind package. Get a quote or find an agent at amfam.com. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly.
American Family Insurance.
Before treating your chronic migraine, 15 or more headache days a month, each lasting 4 hours or more, you're not the only one with questions about Botox. Botox prevents headaches in adults with chronic migraine before they even start, with about 10 minutes of treatment once every 3 months. So ask your doctor if Botox is right for you and if a sample is available.
Effects of Botox may spread hours to weeks after injection, causing serious symptoms. Alert your doctor right away, as difficulty swallowing, speaking, breathing, eye problems, or muscle weakness can be signs of a life-threatening condition. Side effects may include allergic reactions, neck and injection site pain, fatigue, and headache. Don't receive Botox if there's a skin infection. Tell your doctor your medical history, muscle or nerve conditions, and medications, including botulinum toxins, as these may increase the risk of serious side effects.
In a survey, 92% of current users said they wish they talked to their doctor and started Botox sooner. Plus, right now, you may pay $0 for Botox. Learn how AbbVie could help you save on Botox.
Hy-Vee hot deals are super hot this Friday through Sunday. Get a 5-pack of Kraft macaroni and cheese, only $3.88. General Mills giant size cereal, 2 for only $8. Honeycrisp apples, only 99 cents a pound. Hy-Vee Midwest pork chops, only 99 cents. And the savings are hotter than hot on 9-count packs of jumbo muffins fresh from the bakery, only $8.98. Scan the QR code and check out HyVeeDeals.com for more deals.
At JR's Mulch Sales, mulch is all we do, which is why we do it better. We deliver 10 varieties of mulch 7 days a week, right to your door. Call us today.
JR's Mulch Sales, spread it around.
Well, we've had some record-breaking temperatures over the last 4 days, as we've seen 90s and even our lows were breaking records as well. Here's a look at what we've seen over the last 4 days in itself. 90-degree temperatures were the stretch for 4 days, and we're breaking that today as we are looking at a high of 84 degrees for us. We're going to see that sunshine become mostly sunny throughout much of today, but it's definitely going to be warm, just not as warm as it has been, which is great because we're finally going to see some comfortable conditions, as it's not going to be as humid. And for those heading to the farmer's market, it's actually going to be pretty great throughout the course of the day. We'll have much more of what else to expect in a few moments. Until then, back to you, Chris.
Thanks, Julian. Clearly no shortage of films and shows streaming right now. Our Will Loper shares a few of the best in this weekend's Three Things to Watch.
You believe that sneakers are a window to the soul.
If you put enough of yourself into a design, it's gonna hit.
Newly streaming on Disney Plus is the movie Sneakerella.
Sneaker royalty.
Designed for the king brand? That's my dream.
We need to dominate.
SneakerCon, we need something big.
We need a new voice. Someone fresh.
The Cinderella update has Elle dream of making shoes and bumping into the daughter of sneaker royalty.
I just scribble in my notebook.
I'm a stock boy.
This is the real world, not some doodle or some nonsense you're dreaming about.
Wait a second. Did you design these? You're the guy that everybody's been talking about. I really gotta get out of here.
Sneakerella is streaming on Disney Plus now.
The serpent has come.
She was taken for her sins.
No, it was an accident.
Newly streaming on Apple TV Plus is the series The Essex Serpent.
A sea creature has been spotted.
Is there something out there?
That's what I'm here to find out. I've done some research.
Into a mythical beast.
Not mythical, real.
Claire Danes plays Cora, an amateur paleontologist who goes to investigate Essex, where the villagers believe an earthquake has released a serpent.
I'd rather believe in a creature people have actually seen than an invisible god. Is that blasphemy?
We won't get my husband to judge you. No matter how hard you try.
The first two episodes of The Essex Serpent are streaming on Apple TV Plus now.
When I was in high school, I had the perfect life. And all that was left was prom queen.
And newly streaming on Netflix is the movie Senior Year.
Didn't have the heart to change it.
Madonna's now called Lady Gaga. No. Everybody else has got to go on and live their lives. And what, I'm supposed to just jump forward?
Rebel Wilson plays a high school senior who falls into a coma and reawakens 20 years later, still wanting to attend school.
I mean, I just found out there's 8 more Fast and Furious movies.
I want to go back to school, finish my senior year.
They can't let an almost 40-year-old do high school.
High school was just like yesterday for me. It will not be weird at all.
Senior Year is streaming on Netflix now. Those are the three things you need to watch, and this is Will Loper for News 3 Now this morning.
Up next, Senator Tammy Baldwin's visit to PFAS sites. We'll be right back.
When the family can't get enough of your signature dish, get everything you need with Pick and Save free pickup with no surprise fees. So start your cart today. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
Hey, it's me, your dry skin. We go through a lot every day, and Luceramides, my barrier needs to seal in moisture. CeraVe facial moisturizers, developed with dermatologists, continuously deliver 3 essential ceramides to help restore my protective barrier so I can lock in moisture. With CeraVe, we can feel hydrated and look healthy all day. CeraVe facial moisturizing lotions from the number one dermatologist recommended skincare brand.
And I walked right into US Cellular and I said I want to choose any phone in here for free.
What'd he say?
He's insured. Really nice guy. I had my pick of any phone from any brand free, even the newest ones.
Wow.
Yeah.
You got the big screen?
Yeah.
Big storage?
Yeah.
Fits in your pocket?
Fits in my pocket. Yeah, it's a big phone and that's what I wanted and I got what I wanted.
At US Cellular, we put you first. So choose any phone free. Plus, get unlimited data for just $30 a month. US Cellular, America's locally grown wireless.
This ain't about the donor class with their name on trucks. Nor the establishment. Man, they failed us for decades. This is about the ones who work for a living. Just worry about safe streets and buying groceries. Warrior conservatives. This is about Kevin Nicholson, one of us. The Marine who never forgot how to fight. It's in his gut. Conservatives, rise up. We have a leader.
Keeping them safe and healthy, it's our number one job. So even though we've all heard that the COVID-19 vaccine is safe for kids, we still have questions. That's why our family decided to get the facts on the COVID-19 vaccine for kids right away. And to keep taking simple safety steps as we learn more. Help your kids stay safe and in school. Learn more at dhs.wi.gov/COVID-19/parents.
Oh, love that Chevy Blazer.
That's our next SUV.
Love that Equinox.
That's our next SUV.
Nice trailblazer.
It was love at first sight. What?
The Chevy family of SUVs. Find new options. Find new roads.
It's Chevy Sport Utility Spring. Well-qualified buyers can get 0% financing or get a $1,000 cash allowance on all 2022 Equinox models. Chevrolet, the number one selling brand in Wisconsin.
With the Pick and Save app, you can get personalized coupons on top of weekly sales. All for prices that are lower than low. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
And coming up, we're going to take a look at what to expect for your weekend forecast.
Chaos outside Pfizer Forum overnight. We're following new developments in Milwaukee after a shooting near the Bucks playoff game. Thanks for joining us, everyone. Let's send it over first before we get to that breaking news in Milwaukee to Julian C. Wright. He has your Saturday forecast. Hey there, Julian.
And our Saturday forecast is shaping up to be so nice. After the last few days have been so hot for us, well, we're looking at much more cooler conditions as we get into our afternoon. Right now, we can see plenty of sun, even though some clouds are hanging into our skies. But looking ahead, it's going to be relatively mild throughout the rest of our morning. And as we get into the afternoon, those upper 70s and low 80s will be sticking around for us, but winds won't be much of a factor, and the dew points, aka our humidity, won't be much of an issue either. As we see temperatures around the lower to middle 80s as we get into the back end of our afternoon, but plenty of sunshine is going to be right behind it. As we get into the later part of this evening, it's going to be quiet for our Saturday, so definitely enjoy and soak up the sun while we have it. Because as we get into Sunday, well, we're looking at cloudy conditions and even some showers to start to roll in for us overnight. And again, as we get into our Sunday afternoon, as we are looking at some of those showers to even potentially produce some thunderstorms for us as we get into our Sunday evening. We'll take a look at what else to expect for the rest of our weekend coming up in a few moments. Until then, back to you, Chris.
Sounds good, Julian. To that breaking news in Milwaukee now, two separate shootings downtown after the Bucks playoff loss. Police say 17 people were shot and injured just after 11 p.m., about 2 hours after the game ended. This video here shows the scene near Water Street and Highland Avenue. The victims, police say, range in age from 15 to 47 years old. Police say all should survive. Authorities say 10 people were taken into custody and officers recovered 9 guns. The latest from Milwaukee police is that they are still looking for more suspects. Then, about 2 hours earlier and just blocks away, another shooting. 3 people were shot near Pfizer Forum right after the end of the game. New video here taken last night from outside the stadium shows police trying to keep the crowds back from the scene of the crime. The video from our reporter with our news partner, CBS 58, captured at 9:20 last night at MLK in Highland. There, officers are trying to control the crowds. Milwaukee police releasing some new details on that shooting outside of the stadium this morning. Officers have a 29-year-old in custody. The victims include a 16-year-old girl, a 26-year-old man, and a 29-year-old man. All are expected to survive. Police are investigating what led to this shooting. It did not happen in the Deer District, where crowds of fans typically watch games. That is important to note. We will push out updates today through our News 3 Now mobile app, too. As far as the game goes last night, the Bucks were not able to close out their playoff series at home. Giannis Antetokounmpo had 44 points, 20 rebounds, 6 assists, but it was not enough. The Celtics forcing a game 7 now that will be played in Boston. The final score, 108-95 last night. A story trending on channel3000.com this morning. 5 years after the deadly explosion at Didion Milling in Cambria, the company has been federally indicted. 5 people died there May 31st, 2017. The 36-page indictment from a federal grand jury alleges the company failed to keep up with cleanings that were required by federal law, then falsified records to make it look like they did the cleanings. OSHA says dust filters at the plant were not properly ventilated, and that led to the explosion. The company releasing this statement in response to the indictment. We are disappointed the government has decided to pursue these unwarranted charges. And what happened on May 31st, 5 years ago, was a horrible accident, not a criminal act. Take a look at these photos from Oconto County. The Sheriff's Department posting these overnight. This is a department vehicle. They say flood water had covered a 4-foot culvert, and then the officer drove over it, and the pavement gave way. The squad car fell in, the airbags deployed. They got stuck. Luckily, the officer was not hurt and was able to get out even with his canine in tow. New this morning, the Ho-Chunk Nation given the final all clear from the Bureau of Indian Affairs to move ahead with their final design and construction of a new casino in Beloit. Current plans call for the facility to include a hotel, a convention space, water park, dining venue, and retail space. Governor Tony Evers signed off on this development last year.
This project is going to be an economic engine for this entire region. We are looking so forward to the 3,000 construction jobs, to the 1,300 permanent jobs once it's fully complete.
In other news this morning, PFAS, or forever chemicals, have been impacting Wisconsinites across the state. Yesterday, Senator Tammy Baldwin visited a PFAS pollution site. Emily Haugen reports.
Nearly a year and a half later.
It's a huge disruption to life to learn that your water, your drinking water, is contaminated.
Town of Campbell residents are still waiting.
We're concerned about the situation with the water contamination.
Drinking bottled water because the water coming from their taps isn't safe.
We don't know how long Culligan is going to be able to keep giving us good water.
Their wells are contaminated with PFAS, man-made forever chemicals that have been linked to infertility, thyroid disease, and cancer. The town of Campbell is not alone. A handful of the city of La Crosse's municipal wells are also contaminated. They're out of service. The federal government is investing $3.7 million to address the contamination in those wells.
I think what's really important for communities is to have a short-term emergency plan, a sort of midterm plan, and then obviously a long-term vision to cleaning the water up so it's no longer a worry.
But hundreds of private wells in the town of Campbell are contaminated too. That community hasn't received any federal funds.
Lives for the last 2 years.
They shared their frustration with Senator Tammy Baldwin.
Annual budget is only $2.5 million.
Town supervisors and citizens know the town doesn't have the resources to resolve the issue.
Any money that we get is going to have to come from the federal government.
And the clock is ticking.
At my age, we're running out of time.
Emily Haugen reporting there. Seven Wisconsin counties have now reached high levels of community 19 spread, and that is the level that the CDC recommends everyone wear masks indoors. Affected counties include Kenosha, Racine, Vernon, Monroe, La Crosse, Rusk, and Barron counties. Dane County is still in the medium level of spread. While COVID cases are increasing, state health officials say the number of deaths and hospitalizations are not. With more Americans now testing positive for COVID-19 at home, it is becoming more difficult to monitor infection rates. That's why wastewater sampling is more important now than ever. Researchers at the Columbia University Medical Center are studying how wastewater can detect new outbreaks and surges. Hundreds of communities, including some in Wisconsin, are using the technique with full support from the CDC. More than 400 testing sites across the U.S. are enrolled in a CDC program that allows states to compare their sewage data. It's been made a top priority for 2022 by Madison Police, and it's been a talking point with the community ever since the pandemic began. And that's getting violent crime rates in our area back under control. It appears some progress is being made this year. Madison Police Chief Sean Barnes says he's encouraged by it so far. Our Brad Hamilton reports.
Finding solutions to stop violence. That's what Alice Howard has dedicated her life to.
The secret formula that I've seen is people getting to know one another, people being able to communicate together.
But Howard, who is a longtime leader within the Allied Drive community, has been worried about violence within the Madison area for at least the past 2 years. And it turns out that she's not alone. Madison Police Chief Sean Barnes has been open that his top priority is finding a way to calm record-breaking violent crime rates from 2020 and 2021.
We have a plan in place. If we can execute on that plan, we can really end the year on a really, really good note.
And so far, it does appear that 2022 is trending in that direction. There have been four key areas of lower crime rates in the first quarter of this year as compared to last year. This includes a 17% decrease in shots fired incidents, a 14% decrease in burglaries, a 25% decrease in stolen cars, and a 45% decrease in thefts from cars. all of which Chief Barnes is really optimistic about.
The police can only do so much. We're going to be in your neighborhoods. We're going to respond to your calls, and we're going to do the best job that we can, but we do need your help.
But Barnes is also quick to point out that as the weather temps trend upward, usually crime rates do too, making this positive start just that, the first of four very long quarters.
The weather is cooler, people aren't out as much, and you really want to do good strides then, and I think we've done that.
Howard agrees and says that she is ready to do her part.
Police department, politicians, community, neighbors, brothers, sisters, all of us working together. If we all work together, we can accomplish anything.
That was Brad Hamilton reporting. For more on our previous coverage regarding violent crime within the Madison community, head to our website, channel3000.com. Still ahead, what's fueling the crypto crash? That's right after your forecast.
It's the Portage Furniture Store's customer appreciation sale on now, with a huge in-stock inventory of top brands for every room in your home, including all new power lift chairs and always free delivery. The Portage Furniture Store's customer appreciation sale, going on now.
Those brave men and women of our armed forces, generations of them, why should today's burdens fall back onto them? They were there for us. Now let's be there for them. Your local Wisconsin energy providers and the Keep Wisconsin Warm Cool Fund are working together to deliver Wisconsin veterans in crisis heat, power, and help staying in their home. But they can't do it alone. Call to donate today.
Bob's Discount Furniture is the only place you can find my Panther. It's got comfy Bobapedic seating, dual power recliners, and power headrests. My Panther.
Okay.
Light up cup holders, hidden storage, and a drop-down table with reading lights and power outlets in your choice of two colors. With Bob's discount, it's only $19.99. My Panther.
Roar!
Wow! Okay, who's doing that?
Get Bob's discount!
There's a reason big dental bills often come as a shock. Because sometimes you don't realize what's not covered until you get the bill. That's why affordable dental insurance from Physicians Mutual is important. It can give you benefits that go beyond what you get from more limited coverage plans. Because no one likes a big dental bill, especially if you're retired or on a fixed income. For a free information kit, call or go online now. This isn't some discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps cover over 350 procedures, like cleanings, fillings, crowns, bridges, root canals, even dentures, at any dentist you want. Dental insurance from Physicians Mutual Insurance Company helps cover preventive care, basic work, and major procedures with no deductibles and no annual maximum. For your free information kit with all the details, call now or visit sendinfokit.com.
Physicians Mutual, Physicians Mutual.
It's the Portage Furniture Store's customer appreciation sale on now, with a huge in-stock inventory of top brands for every room in your home, including hundreds of Lazy Boy recliners and always free delivery. The Portage Furniture Store's customer appreciation sale going on now.
Four students and one teacher on a mission.
Trying to rethink how schools could be.
Chris Stanford takes you inside a Madison micro school where the students have a big say in what they learn about. Eye on Education, Sunday on News 3 Now at 10.
Want to know right now what the weather will be like tomorrow? Download the First Warn Weather app and you'll get my customized forecast for tonight and tomorrow.
The First Warn Weather app. Get it now. Powered by News 3 Now.
And taking a look outside, as we can see, some of that cloud cover is still starting to break up for us this morning. Well, temperatures are still pretty mild as well. Looking at 68 degrees here in Madison, humidity is not too bad either as we're waking up this morning. Just comfortable enough. So if you have any outdoor activities you need to do, from mowing the lawn, getting your car washed, definitely go out and do it. And those who are going to be at graduation, it's going to be pretty nice for us. The temperatures in southern Wisconsin, 66 in Janesville, 65 for Platteville, and the Dew points are not too bad at all. As I mentioned, we're into the 50s for many of us, even though towards the southeast, we're around the 60s, but it's still not too bad. And we'll start to see those dew points fall as we get into the later part of this afternoon, where we're going to see warmer temperatures back into the 80s and plenty of sunshine. Back to you, Chris.
Thanks, Julian. In a span of 24 hours, the world of virtual currency known as crypto cash lost about $200 billion in revenue. Some are calling it the crypto crash. CBS's Manuel Bjorkas has more.
Fortune favors the brave.
Cryptocurrencies have shot into the public arena, with sports stars and celebrities endorsing them as the future of finance. In Miami, the crypto craze includes the world's largest Bitcoin convention and a mayor who wants to make the city a crypto hub.
Welcome to the future of finance.
Unveiling a statue last month symbolizing the bullish rise of the unregulated online currency, even vowing to take his city salary in Bitcoin.
So this doesn't change your approach to cryptocurrency coming into the city?
Absolutely not. Not one bit. You can't change your approach just because the market has a bad week or a bad day. This is about the core of the technology.
Interest rate hikes have led to a sell-off of stocks and spooked investors from risky bets, sending crypto plummeting this year. From Bitcoin's 39% drop to stablecoin Luna's near total loss in just the last week, it's estimated investors have lost a combined $1 trillion. Remy Tito is out $2 million, but says he can take the hit.
I can see online right now all the people saying they lost their life saving, they lost everything. And the first thing is, don't invest money you cannot afford to lose.
That is the golden rule, says CBS News business analyst Jill Schlesinger, who also says don't rule out crypto yet.
This happened in the dot-com boom of the 1990s. This is a lot of people who believe in this technology. They're not sure how it's going to work out, but they are true believers.
Among them, Miami's mayor, who says crypto investments here have brought in jobs and dollars. Still, it's estimated 40% of Bitcoin investors are currently underwater and will lose money unless they ride it out. Manuel Bajorquez, CBS News, Miami.
Still ahead, some encouragement that it's never too late to give up on your dreams. As we look outside this morning, look at those blue skies. Quite a change from those storms that pushed through last night and the cloudy start this morning. Julian's tracking some cooler weather and our next shot at some rain when we come back.
Look Who's Three is sponsored by Three Bears Resort Indoor Water Park and Conference Center in Warrens, Wisconsin. At JR's Mulch Sales, mulch is all we do, which is why we do it better. We deliver 10 varieties of mulch 7 days a week, right to your door. Call us today.
JR's Mulch Sales, spread it around.
This is how we do it.
Pick and Save, we believe it takes the right team to bring you fresh produce. That's why we partner with farmers who grow only the best. And that level of teamwork means better, fresher options time and time again. Because working together is truly what it takes to be fresh for everyone. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
I'd love to have you
stay.
How about this?
It's going to work. I think so, too.
American Family Insurance wants to help you bring your dream home to life. New homeowners can save an average of 22%. Get a quote or find an agent at amfam.com.
American Family Insurance.
I'm Sarah Godlewski. I'm at the Supreme Court, where it looks like Ron Johnson is going to get exactly what he wants. Overturning Roe v. Wade, reinstating Wisconsin's cruel abortion ban, and putting doctors in jail. But that's not what Wisconsinites want. We don't want politicians making healthcare choices for women. I'm Sarah Godlewski, and I approve this message because as your senator, I will never sit by and allow our rights to be stripped away. Join me. Let's fight back and defeat Ron Johnson.
As summer approaches, is your house ready? Over 7 out of 10 homes are poorly insulated. Is yours? Here are some of the signs. Is your house too cold in the winter? Is it too hot in the summer? Does your furnace and AC run almost nonstop? Do you have different temperatures in different rooms? Are your energy bills too high? You don't need a new home. You need better insulation. Call now before our busy summer season and get a $500 early bird discount.
USA Insulation.
At JR's Mulch Sales, mulch is all we do, which is why we do it better. We deliver 10 varieties of mulch 7 days a week, right to your door. Call us today.
JR's Mulch Sales, spread it around.
News 3 Now.
Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
And we are just going to have a great start to our Saturday morning as the clouds are starting to clear up for us as we get things rolling. Well, temperatures are also pretty mild as well. 68 degrees here in Madison. And any clouds that we're going to see for right now are just going to be for pretty much right now. So as we get into our afternoon, we'll start to see plenty of blue and plenty of sunshine. Temperatures around southern Wisconsin, 73 degrees in Janesville already with 65 in Platteville. A bit cooler for areas than to the northwest, but we're all looking at mild conditions as we're starting things out for us. The good news is that dew points aren't really high at all for us. We're actually pretty comfortable in comparison to what we've been feeling for the last couple of days. Honestly, this is what our scale is looking at. As long as we're in the 55 to 60 degree range or even around the 55 range, that's when we're really on the comfortable side in terms of the humidity outside. So if you have anything that you need to do in terms of washing the car or even mowing the lawn, definitely get out there and do it for today. It's going to be warmer into the afternoon, but we will still see a pretty nice and comfortable start to our morning. Plenty of sunshine, as I mentioned, as we get into the afternoon hours. And thanks to the high pressure system, we're looking at lots of dry conditions for us. As the storm system is moving its way out of the upper Midwest, we're going to be looking at a pretty quiet Saturday for us and a warm one on tap as well. Now, as we get into the rest of our Saturday nights, we'll start to see clouds start to build back once again, as we are looking for a quick, brief system to roll in over nights to bring in some showers into areas of southern Wisconsin, but it looks to clear out as we get into the later part of our Sunday morning. But we're looking at another round of some more rain coming into our Sunday afternoon and glowing into our Sunday evening. We have chances of those rain rounds to start to bring in some thunderstorms for us, especially as we get into the later part of our evening. But that again looks to clear up as we get into the overnight hours transitioning into our Monday morning. But the rain in itself, not looking for a whole lot. It's just a nice little dusting of sprinkle of some rain for us, but this weekend in itself is definitely going to be shaping up really nicely for us. Today, plenty of sunshine, feels like summer, and tomorrow's going to feel like spring as we're looking at more showers for us, around 68 degrees, but nice light breezes, and it's just going to feel flat out great for us throughout the rest of today and even heading into our tomorrow. And aside from that, we do have a couple of shower chances and even some potential thunderstorms later into next week, but aside from that, folks, we are looking at some real cool conditions for us over the next few days. It's going to feel a lot more like spring as we're into the 60s and 70s, and the back and forth is going to continue throughout next week as well. We do, again, have a couple of days where we could see some shower chances, but for the most part, it's pretty smooth sailing, and it's definitely feeling a lot more like spring instead of that summer that we had last week.
Yeah, finally able to get out and enjoy some of that weather. It's just been too hot and muggy this last week.
Too hot, too muggy.
How many records did we break in a row?
Four.
Four record-breaking days of heat.
It's ridiculous.
I think I can speak for all of us when I say it's time to cool down.
Absolutely. Right? We need that break.
Thanks, Julian. All right, stick with News 3 Now all weekend long. Brad will have your top stories tonight at 6 and 10. But first, the 80-year-old woman who just graduated college. We're back in a moment.
More Americans are growing their own vegetables than ever before. At Garden Mats, we're here to help people supplement their food supply with fresh, organic vegetables. Whether you are a beginner, novice, or master gardener, Garden Mats make gardening a breeze. Spend your summers trying to keep up with each other, not your weeds. Go to GardenMats.com and plan your garden today.
Right now with Papa Murphy's, we've got a great deal.
Which means I make more great pizza.
It's not an I thing, Dad. It's a we thing.
Get 25% off after spending $25 when you order online. Order now at PapaMurphys.com.
Summer's here, and with an exciting new Toyota, you can take a trip to the beach, the city,
the mountains,
the desert, ooh, the bayou. I think I'm sinking. Definitely sinking.
Every new Toyota comes with Toyota Care, a 2-year or 25,000-mile maintenance plan and roadside assistance. See your local Toyota dealer or visit Toyota.com to learn more.
Your summer starts here.
Toyota, let's go places.
Hey, everybody, who's coming to the big show? It's Fetty!
Saturday, June 11th at Ho-Chunk Gaming and Casino in Wisconsin Dells, an all-day outdoor event. Come out for classic cars, trucks, and motorcycles during the day and stay for the concert at night. Featuring country superstar Trace Atkins, Runaway Jew, The Mascot Theory, and Beth Killeen. All benefiting heat and housing for heroes. Visit VetAWI.com for details and to purchase tickets for Trace Atkins.
I just scratch my head over these career politicians. They get in there and they just never want to leave. I'm going to give this my all for 4 years, work very hard. I'm going to do it for the greater good of all the people of Wisconsin, not the special interests. I think the lobbyists are not going to like me at all. They're going to be very frustrated. I'm not beholden to them. Didn't take any money from them, won't take any money from them. I'm going to do what's right for all the people of Wisconsin.
Tim Michaels for governor.
Why would Stanton Optical choose a spokesbird?
They're not your typical eye care company. I'm not your typical penguin. We're a team. There's no I in eye care. Wait.
Get two pairs of glasses plus a free eye exam, anti-glare lenses, and same-day service for only $79.
Newsstream Now is taking action, reaching out to our community to lend a helping hand.
Taking action by teaming with our neighbors and local leaders to help make this amazing community we share a better place to live.
Taking action for South Central Wisconsin. Newsstream Now.
Mission Unstoppable, Saturday morning at 9 on News 3 Now.
We've been talking a lot about graduating here in Madison this morning, but a Nebraska woman is celebrating her college graduation at 80 years old. Waverly Monroe reports.
Madeline Adams has been waiting roughly 6 decades for this moment.
Madeline Elizabeth Adams.
The 80-year-old first started at UNO when the mascot was still the Indians back in 1960.
Well, life happened, okay? Expecting, married, second child, third child, divorce, moved out of state.
Adams would move to Missouri and then work real estate for 15 years before ending up in Honolulu and then Arizona before settling with her daughter, Robin Wright.
My daughter who lives in Texas, she's here today. She begged me to come visit her.
And while getting her mother moved in, Wright noticed something.
I noticed that she had 40 credits from UNO. And I said, Mom, why don't you just finish?
Adams enrolled and did online classes, crediting her daughter for pushing her across the finish line.
She's the wind beneath my wings. She really is.
Right.
And she's my biggest cheerleader.
Though Wright would tell you her mom's flying fine on her own.
And she would always just kind of jokingly say we were the smart ones. But I was like, Mom, you made us. Yeah. You're the one who taught us.
Wright calls her an inspiration.
Because I didn't realize the whole thing was that, you know, that they were 19 when they had all, you know, 22 by the time they had all three of them. And she really dropped out to work for us.
Adams says she's finally putting a period on her education career.
I always taught my children, don't start anything you can't finish. So I had to be the example, right?
Adams plans to take her degree and use it for her volunteer work.
How about that? Congratulations to her and all of our graduates that'll be walking across that stage, and even the ones who won't this weekend.
Yeah,
it's going to be gorgeous out there. Everybody's headed downtown Madison today, and finally got some less humid conditions out there.
Absolutely. Honestly, it's perfect, especially for the graduates today, because even though it may feel like summer, at least we're not going to be looking at any kind of rain in our forecast for today. But then that's not going to be the same story throughout the rest of the week. So we will have some chances of some rain or even a potential thunderstorm, but spring-like temperatures will be back next week. Aside from that, definitely enjoy our Saturday, because 84 sunny with no humidity just sounds like a dream to me.